Sidney Crosby and Elias Lindholm in the circle. We got a face-off on Fifth Avenue. We're underway here on a Saturday night on Sportsnet Pittsburgh. Here's O'Connor snapping it down low for Eller off the end wall. Finds Carlson, centers through everyone back to Pedersen. Snaps it to O'Connor, hands it off to Eller on goal. A snapper is shoulder to side and tight by Markstrom. Eller behind the net to O'Connor as this line goes towards centers. Loose atop the crease. It's bouncing around. Zadorov up the wall, kept in by Carlson. To Erik Karlsson, grips it, surveys, back to Malkin, one-timer block, put on goal by Crosby. Markstrom got the leg on it, it's loose, it bounces towards the net, but not in. How did that not go as the Flames clear?
Money, commits for hooking.
You get a hooking call on Gino, only way you can stop him. It was Gensel, what a spin move off Tanev. Look at Gensel's face, he couldn't believe it.
Malkin wins the draw, Raquel to Karlsson. Just inside the line, over to Malkin, one-timer off iron! Blew it past Markstrom, but not into the net.
He did it last night also, maybe it's a sign. All iron for Gino.
Passing to Raquel, cross-ice feed, Malkin throws it in front, Crosby shoots, save! Markstrom, it's loose, bouncing around, Carlson to the backhand, across to Crosby, twists it, Markstrom the save!
Markstrom saying, what's all these bodies doing in my blue paint? Look at the puck movement. East to west, Crosby's flying into the slot. And then the great play by Carlson to pull that back off and find Crosby. Of course, starting on the penalty kill here. We'll have to get through a minute and 2 seconds of this Graves penalty before they can get back to work.
Two of them muscle their way after each other as the puck rolls deeper into the pen zone. Not cleared. Ruzicka's got it. Down low for Dubé. Wrist shot. And getting a piece of that. Nedeljkovic may have hit iron as it goes out of play.
And big right here. And we'll get a look at it. Iron.
On the half wall. Throws it back door and a good stick there. Deflects it wide. Rusty's going to sprint after the puck. And there he goes. Short-handed. Into the Calgary zone. To the backhand. Brian Rust. Backhander goes wide. Eller curls it on net, and that hit the outside of the cage, and they got to get back, because now here come the Flames, 3-on-2, as Huberdeau comes in right side, Wrister missed the net. Lindholm, cross ice for Anderson, he'll wind and blast, save Nedeljkovic, big rebound, comes back to Lindholm, in the slot, throws it down the one-time blast, they score, Matthew Coronato. First NHL goal is a power play tally, and it's 1-0 Calgary.
Straight back down, establish some zone entry and zone time in their power play setup. And Lindholm, the magician, just kind of gets it there. And Coronato off on the side of the net. You see guys taking these shots from those bad angles. Find a lane and have to get that goalie to squeeze to that post. A little bit of a break this period as they try to chase down this Calgary Flames team who's just up by one.
Penguins trying to finish this early season back-to-back off with 2 points. They have some work to do as the third period gets underway. Flames with the 1-0 advantage. Crosby creates a turnover right away, knocking the puck off Mangiapane and muscles it down low. Bouncing puck, corralled by Gensel, up top Letang. Snapshot, hit a body, went wide. Rush chips it on net, it scores! 18 seconds for 17, and the Penguins have tied this game in one, thanks to Brian Rust.
What amazing job by Sid off the rush to enter the zone. As you can see, he just stayed with it and banked it in off Markstrom, who's been unbelievable here today, and maybe that's just one and the way you're going to get it done. But Sid, just a power move, entering the zone, fighting up. He's a puck-hounding, disturbing guy, can use his speed, but has the skill, hands, playmaking ability to be a difference maker. And he's a guy I'm looking to have a big year and bounce back, and here we go.
It's Smith from Malkin, Wrister, he scores! Riley Smith wires it past Markstrom, and the Penguins with 2 goals in the first 41 seconds of the third take a 2-1 lead.
Didn't go the other way. Look at Graves, he stays up and above Backlund. And then it's just accepting pressure, does Raquel to Gino on the overload. And it's easier said than done. He just had to bury this. When you look at this play, what a pass by Gino to avoid that slide blocking.
Penguins get an offensive zone draw here after the icing, and Mike Sullivan quickly sending the Crosby line out there. He wins the draw to Letang. Across Gensel, shoots and scores! First of the season for Jake Gensel, and the Penguins add to their lead. It's 3-1.
Kind of, he gets lost. Look at Jake come off the boards and get all the way across. Talk about chaos and trying to pick up guys, sort it out. It's just so smoothly executed play.
Started this season on a three-game point streak. And as Harkins plays it off the draw, but not out. Anderson down low for Huberdeau. Lindholm intercepts, banks it up the wall. Gensel battling for it, couldn't come up with it. Kadri does, down low, centers a shot there, and a great stop by Nedeljkovic in tight on Lindholm. Shot deflected to the near side, picked up by Kadri. He goes up top, bombs away for Hanifin, that's wide. Crashes into the end wall, tied up there, loose puck. There's a sea of bodies, dig for it, it's Letang, nearly took it away. It does come free, but back to the point, Hanifin chops it, blocked on its way to the net. Malkin for Ricard Raquel. Over the line. Didn't handle the puck. It flutters to the near corner. Hanifin pops it to the line, but kept in by Smith. He'll drop it for Malkin. Charging to the net. Shoots. Scores! Gino Machino with an exclamation point to this third period. And it's 4-1.
Turnover here and a flub clear by Hanifin. And that's all they needed to go on the attack. And who was there to pick it off? Riley Smith, Johnny on the spot. Draws players to him, drops it to Evgeny Malkin. Finds a hole on Markstrom.
Into the high slot, Lindholm. Passes for Rasmus Anderson. Cross ice, Lindholm. Skates to stick, carries behind the net. Hit to the ice by Letang. Mangiapane for Hanifin. He'll snap it. That hit a stick. Bounces around. Comes to Huberdeau. Backhander deflects in. And the Flames get one back. As Huberdeau put the puck to the goal. And he's going to lead the handshake line. It's 4-2.
See as it gets put in into the net here. As Rust gets a piece of it. Another block. That's 6 for him here tonight. And it just gets thrown to the net with Anderson crashing back door. And it hits Gensel's skate as him and Letang kind of came together. I don't know what Nedeljkovic could have done to try to get a hold of that one. Just an unlucky break.
Crosby and Lindholm this time on the draw. Lindholm wins the faceoff, but stepping right to it is Gensel. He'll take it through center. Look for the empty net. Off the post!
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, he's going to be thinking about this one. Did his first of the year. He had all the time and measured it, got his head up, took a look.
It rolls back to Rasmus Anderson. He'll find Huberdeau, 30 seconds in the game. Anderson moves around Gensel. Pass picked off by Gensel. Hands it off to Rust. Racing through center to the empty net. No mistake that time. Brian Rust with the dagger. And the Penguins with a 5-2 lead with 22 seconds to go.
Gensel kind of stumbles. And Sid kind of recognizes that, the instincts to cover up and drop into that lane. Which caused the pass to mix up, and from the other side of the ice, it gets up ice. Gensel
will carry it in as the fans rise to their feet here at PPG Paints Arena. The Penguins are going to pull off a perfect weekend back-to-back with a two-point party on Fifth Avenue in a 5-2 win over the Calgary Flames here on Saturday night.